back at his Extra Butter. Thanks for hanging out with us. In a minute, we'll talk about the Oscar nominations right now, what you can see this weekend at the box office. If you're looking for something because there's no Harry Potter movie out right now, there's a great youth-oriented movie you should probably see. The Kid Who Would Be King. What are our thoughts right now, having seen the trailer or having seen the movie The Kid Who Would Be King?
I'm so excited about the retelling of a story that we all know and love so very much.
Yeah, it's about King Arthur in modern-day times. And hello, the kid cast in this is crazy good. Yeah. It's Andy Serkis's son, people.
Yeah, one of the greatest motion capture actors ever.
Yeah.
I was disappointed.
I didn't know that.
Why is that?
I thought this movie was about LeBron James. The whole time.
It's not a basketball
film. I was watching it saying, what is he going to do?
So we'll get to that movie. That's a great idea. But in the meantime, this movie, I selected at random a junior reporter from New York City.
You talking about your niece that you paid off?
That's not random.
Yes, it is my niece. And yes, I did bribe her. There might be some American Girl swag. In the meantime, she's standing by right now. Hey, Lila.
Hey, Uncle Mark.
Where are you?
I'm in New York City interviewing the Kid Who Could Be King cast.
Is the cast with you now?
Yeah.
We'll get to it.
Okay, I'll start with you, Sir Patrick, because I've heard you're a real knight.
Oh, a real knight?
Yeah.
Yes, I am.
Do you like it?
Yes, and I'm very happy about that. I was knighted by the Queen about 8 years ago.
And how do you become a knight?
I think the reason for mine was services to the theater. Okay. And something rather magical happened because you have to kneel in front of her. And then all of a sudden she had a sword in her hand and I had no idea where it came from. And then she did the on both shoulders and the sword went away. And I didn't see, I don't know, maybe I was being a little overexcited, but I didn't see where it came from or where it went to.
That's the magic of it.
It must have been.
You guys worked with swords. Did any of you guys hit each other on accident or no?
Well, one of our peers, Dean, who plays Bedders, he actually had a little incident.
He had a little accident where he stabbed himself in the foot on like our second day of shoot. So that was kind of scary, but He was fine. It was
fine.
A little cut.
He recovered.
And Rihanna, so you're the girl in the movie. Do you want to have a movie where you're the queen?
I like her. It would be cool, but I don't know. I feel like Kay being a lady gives her that sense of power. Like, she's the foundation. Mm. She's who Alex can rely on, and I like the fact that they have that trust. It gives her a lot of power, so it's cool.
Sir Patrick, when your three favorite combinations of food was chicken, vanilla ice cream, and cherry soda, what is your favorite junk food combination?
When I was a child, we were quite poor when I grew up, and the one thing I loved eating more than anything else was two slices of bread with potato crisps inside. Mm. And the important thing about a potato crisp sandwich is you put lots of potato crisps in and then you squash them down so that they break.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you, sweetie.
Well, that's it, Uncle Mark. Back to you.
Awesome job, Lila.
Thank you, Lila. Nice work there. Niecy?
No offense, but she kind of killed it. She did a lot better than you ever have done with Patrick Stewart or a lot of people. No offense.
She got him to talk about being a real-life knight.
I wouldn't have even thought about that.
No. Nice work.
Good job.
All right, I'm going to double your American Girl swag in honor of
you. I might need to hire you for some projects.
We'll make it happen. I know her agent.